There are so many candlestick patterns, and there are people who get confused as to which candlestick pattern should be really followed. Many people ask me, Rachna, which is your favorite candlestick pattern? So I thought of making a separate video on this. My two favorite candlestick patterns are morning star and evening star. Morning star denotes the start of an uptrend, while evening star denotes a start of the downtrend. By the way, sun is a star. Hi guys, CA Rachna Ranade here, and I welcome you all to a brand new video on morning star and evening star pattern. By the way, you might get a feeling that why Rachna just said that sun is a star, but you know, I thought that there are so many things that we learn during school, during college, during our offices, that some basic things which we learn during school and which we never ever actually practically implemented during our offices sometimes tend to get forgotten. So I just thought of brushing it up for you. So let's start with the morning star candlestick pattern. Okay, just in case you don't know about what are candlesticks, you want your basics to be very clear, don't forget to watch my separate video which I've already posted on YouTube on basics of candlesticks. Okay, so what's a morning star candlestick pattern? It's basically a three candle pattern. Now, three candles, out of which the very first candle is generally a big red candle. Okay, you can see that the body of that big red candle is pretty big and the wicks are not that big. Okay, all these terminologies of what is body of a candle, what is the wick of the candle, everything is explained in the same video which I referred to just a minute ago. Second, here you can see is a doji candlestick. I'm going to explain what is a doji in the immediate next section of the video. Okay, and it is always followed by a big green candle. Okay, so when you get all these three candles back to back, then we call this, all three candles put together, we call this as a morning star candlestick pattern. Okay, if this candlestick pattern appears at the end of a downward trend, this pattern now is a bull, is a reversal pattern basically. So after a big downfall, if you see a morning star, that is a beginning of an upward trend. Okay, so when can you enter into the stock or when can you enter the index? It is only when you see the third candle, you see the confirmation candle. When a big green candle is formed, that can be a confirmation, after which you can enter as a buy call. While I was discussing the morning star candlestick pattern, I talked about a big red, a big green, and there was a doji in between. Now, what is this doji? Doji in Japanese means a mistake or a blunder, but I mean, nothing to do with our video right now. There's no blunder or mistake in the video. Don't worry on that. Okay, it's just the Japanese meaning of the word doji. Okay, now how is doji formed? It's a typical case where opening and closing price is more or less the same. The high price is way above the open or close price, and the low is also way below the open or low price. You'll be amazed to know that there are four types of dojis. Now, which are the four types? You can see here. One is a neutral doji. Now, what is this neutral doji? Here you can very clearly see that it's like a perfect bisection. Okay, it's bisecting the straight candle at exactly the mid part of the candle. Okay, so that is called as a neutral doji. So the open and close is exactly in between of the highs and lows. Okay, second one is a dragonfly doji. Now what can you see here? In a dragonfly doji, the open and close is at a very close point. The high is also a little bit closer to the open and close, but the low is way too low as compared to the open and close price. So what will happen? Let us understand. Assume that the open and close both is at 100, just as an example. And if I say high is at 20, is at 120, okay, then the low will be somewhere around 40 or 50. Okay, it is that low. It can't be somewhere around 80. Okay, so that is an example of a dragonfly doji. What happens with a long-legged doji? In a long-legged doji, you can see that the wicks are also very, tall. The shadows are also very tall. So in a long-legged doji, the high will be very high. The low will also be pretty low. That's an example of a long-legged doji. And the last one is a gravestone doji, where you might have understood that gravestone doji is very Exactly, I can say it's exactly opposite of a dragonfly doji, where open close is again same. But now, why opposite of dragonfly? Because here you can see that the open close are pretty close to the low point rather than its high point. Okay, but be it be a neutral doji or a dragonfly or a long-legged doji or a gravestone doji, all indicate that something is going to change. It's basically that neither the buyers are winning nor the sellers are winning. Neither the bulls are winning nor the bears are winning. Everyone is trying to take it to a specific direction, but finally open close is more or less at a similar price. Let me give you a practical example on Morningstar. This is the Nifty 50 chart for you. Can you spot the Morningstar? 3 to 5 seconds, I've already waited. Can you spot the Morningstar? Yes, that is where it is. Now you can see that a very clear-cut Morningstar appears somewhere in the month of March. Okay, after which the markets have just gone up. It's not like a steep rise, but yes, slowly and steadily, it has increased quite a bit. That is how the Morningstar works. Okay, I'll give you one more example. I had given you the example of Nifty. Now let me give you an example of HDFC Bank. This is also a daily chart. Can you see the Morningstar? Yes, it is around November, correct? Here you can see a very clear big red kind of a doji. It's not a perfect doji, followed by big green. And then you can see that the stock has risen and risen and risen. That is the magic of the Morningstar candlestick pattern. Now let's understand evening star pattern quickly. It's actually exactly the opposite of a Morningstar. Now you need to tell me how the evening star will work. First of all, number one is going to be a big green candle, followed by what? Doji, and then followed by a big red candle. Okay, when will it appear? If it appears at the end of an uptrend, okay, there's a good uptrend and then you see an evening star, this is the sign of a reversal. There is a great chance that the market or that specific stock will move in a downward direction. Okay, I hope you have understood what's an evening star. It was way easy. If you have understood Morningstar appears, if it appears at the end of downtrend, it's a reversal, and then markets will reverse in the upward direction. What will happen to an evening star? Assume there's an uptrend first, then evening star appears, it's a reversal trend, then it is going to go down. Okay, I'm going to give a homework for you. You have to check the daily chart of DMart. Okay, so just try to check how does the candlestick pattern of DMart chart overall looks like, and see if you can spot either a morning star or an evening star. And when am I going to give you the answer of that? I hope you have liked this short and sweet video on Morningstar and Eveningstar. If you want to learn about technical analysis more in detail, just don't forget to visit my website rachanaranade.com, wherein you will find an entire course, detailed course on technical analysis. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Till then, take care. Jai Hind and bye-bye.